Hi, today is December 2nd, and I've got Tinsel's babies, six of them, born on October 18th. They're 6 weeks old a couple of days ago, but with six babies, and this was a small mama, she was, I think, struggling to feed them. And so they're still pretty small. I've been kind of fattening them up on some bug and grub food, our insectivore food, but they're still pretty small. Each one of these babies should go home with a container of that food, bug and grub, insectivore food. I'll tell you the difference. Before I start this video, I'm just gonna do a little education on it. I look at the bug and grub food as like a formula. So instead of just feeding a cat food, this has got crushed up crickets and it's got mealworms and soldier flies. It has soldier fly larvae. It's got Missouri insectivore food. So it is like super highly nutritious and it would be a meal replacement for the first, however long the container lasts. So first couple of weeks, and it would really be good for each one of these babies. So with that being said, I'll turn the phone over to Ben.
Here you go, baby.
And I'll start with this little active one. She's out and about quite a bit. She's got a little pink dot, baby pink dot on her butt. Now, do you remember when we just did those half and half a couple weeks ago? She's a half and half, but she's a blonde. And so she's so cute. She's got the real light brown and then the white on the end. And she's super, super sweet. Here, let me see if I can get her to go into a ball.
She's busy.
She is busy. I can pet her forehead real easily. But now we got to take your picture.
Hi.
There we go. Gotcha. Now we got a picture for you. But she's easy to handle, she's easy to hold, and she's like kind of on the move. So she's quite fun. Put her on this little baby wheel and they get a little nervous on the baby wheel at first. So it's quite cute that they're, when they start to explore with it. This litter has three girls and three boys. Actually I grabbed a boy, I'm gonna do the three girls first. Okay, this one's a girl. Okay, so this one has a magenta dot on her butt, and she's got a little bit more uniform color. She is still a blonde. She's got a couple little pinto spots on her. She's really cute because look at, she's got two different color ears. She has one pink left ear. Mm-hmm. She's kicking herself in her face. Like, what's happening here? There she goes. A pink left ear, and then she's got a brown right ear. It's a struggle. The struggle's real. I wasn't doing it to you. You were doing it to yourself. There you go. Come on out. Anyways, she's just beautiful. Those two color ears, I love it when they have that. That's just such cuteness. Just can't stand the cuteness. Yeah, and these guys are learning to put their quills back nicely. 6 weeks, it's kind of a... We don't know if it'll happen or if it won't happen. She's got one like
crazy quill
over there. Okay, let's put you in the wheel. That's magenta dot. I feel like our wheel is leaning forward. She's like, get me off this contraption. There you go. Let's find the other girl. Here's purple. She was like thoroughly burrowed down. Okay. This one is a purple dot. She's got a little swoosh of pinto white around her. Definitely darker. She's not, I wouldn't say a salt and pepper. She's more brown, but she's not a blonde. You got more bedding stuck up on you. Hi there. She's doing her little dance moves.
Back and forth, back.
Now I add the arm movements. She lets us pet her face nice. She's got her quills going back. Real traditional brown. Okay, there's the three girls. Now on to the three boys. There, try that. have each one of these boys like curling in and trying to go to bed here. Mm. Just doing a little underbelly petting here, trying to help him wake up. This little dude's got a green dot on his butt. He's got a couple pinto spots on him. Again, he's a, what do we call that one? Cappuccino brown, mocha brown.
Okay. Yeah.
You know, he's not super dark. Yeah, I'll turn him and try and get him in a ball. Now, I can tell that he stuck his head in somebody else's butt after I did the fingernail polish. So he's got a little bit of light blue up here on his forehead.
That's funny.
But I'm going to be marking him as green. Okay, so if I have a hedgehog that's afraid to come out of a ball, I want to do him face down so he can smell a little bit better. Oh, he's like, that camera's kind of scary. There. See, yeah, it's okay. I'll get you. There. Hi, dude.
That's good.
Yeah. Still a little timid if I try to go to pet his face, but my goodness, he's only 6 weeks old. There, he's letting me real easily. Look at how small these guys are. They're pretty tiny. This mama is not a big mama. She's actually quite small. So for her to even have six babies was really quite surprising to me. All right. Here's the one that he was sniffing at because he's got a powder blue dot on his butt. So that's where he got it from. He's a burrower, so he is definitely having fun playing. Okay, so we've got a blonde. And I'm going to say a blonde pinto because I see lots of white pinto spots in here. So this will be my blonde pinto. It's like, don't come at me too fast. Dear. So let me sniff you first. Okay. Let's see if we can get a photo shoot of you now.
Hi, dude.
Think you got something there that I can screenshot?
Right there.
There.
There's the pose.
There's the pose. Here we go. Hi. You let me pet you nicely. I'm going to kind of claim your forehead. Well, that camera scares you, doesn't it? Okay. Okay, you get to try the wheel. Everybody tries the wheel today.
Nope. Oh, I got poop. All right. You need some help?
There you go. Okay, here's our last baby. He's got a red dot on his butt right here. He's got little white pinto spots all over him. He is a blonde. He was sleeping, so we'll see how he wakes up for us. Schedules for babies right now, I actually get asked this a lot. They're really not on quite a specific set schedule yet. They're up a couple of hours, down a couple of hours. Got to get up and eat, and then I got to go back to sleep. And so almost just like human babies, they're just not quite on a normal schedule. So we do want to let them sleep, you know, a solid 8 hours. But if I notice hedgehogs are up and playing, then I encourage it. Yeah, this one gives me his forehead. Maybe it's the big bling on the back of my phone.
Yeah, maybe.
Hi,
little dude. He's like, let me go back to sleep. I want to go back to sleep.
Okay. Let me try and answer some questions that I'm getting lots of text messages. If you have a deposit paid for a Christmas baby, then you would not be choosing from these babies. If you were to choose one of these babies, it would need to be picked up within 7 days. Now, with that being said, I have 30 babies that are coming available between now and Christmas week. And then on Christmas Day, I have an additional 35 babies that I'm hoping I can have weaned and ready a couple of days before Christmas. That's our goal. If you're thinking that you want to give your child a hedgehog for Christmas, then you can always, if you wanted to choose from that second batch of 35 babies, then you could always stop over, pick up our habitat kit, wrap the habitat kit, put it underneath the Christmas tree, and then tell your kiddo at Christmas time, guess what? Here's a website you get to go on and you get to choose any baby you like. And kids love that. They get super excited about picking their own baby. So once you choose a baby on our website, and I will continually post them over the next couple of weeks, then it has to be picked up within 7 days. I don't want 60 hedgehogs that people are all picking up Christmas Eve day and that I've been boarding for 4 weeks. So that's kind of a goal. If you have any questions about that, let me know. Again, we talked about at the beginning of the video, the bug and grub food. So those are the bug and grub food containers that I'm gonna look at as like pure formula. It's really good nutrition for these babies, and with them all being little, they should have that. We also carry soldier flies, we carry mealworms, and we carry soldier fly larvae. Super healthy. These guys are insectivores, so all the food, the bugs that we carry are freeze-dried. You can try live ones. We just didn't have a huge success with live bugs with our hedgehogs, and so we, like that hedgehog is like falling asleep face down. I'll just sleep right here. Let me help you off your wheel there, dude. There you go. Sleep right there. We kind of do a lot of talking about products. If you are purchasing a habitat kit from us, you know, we started exploring the difference between these cute little tree houses and also with igloos. And we were finding that the hedgehogs were really preferring, look at, there's one right in there. They were really preferring the dark tree houses that get real black versus the translucent see-through igloos. They're both available. I also tell people that with it being winter time, please consider doing a habitat heater. We want hedgehog habitats to be between 72 and 78 degrees. And with it, you know, people even use air conditioners in the summertime. We just use those habitat heaters kind of year round. So they're a good thing to protect your investment, give your critter a warm home that they live in. And people ask me about mirrors all the time, because this one like is really looking at herself in the mirror going back and forth. We do mirrors in our habitats because we think hedgehogs like to look at themselves a lot. So finding a cute little mirror for your habitat's always fun. Anyways, we're at 14 minutes, long video. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions, text me and I will try to get back with you as soon as I can. Bye.
Bye.